We all know that governments and private companies spy on us through our mobile phones. But the big question is, do governments have the technology to take control of a mobile phone anywhere in the world with just the phone number without the victim opening a link or a suspicious SMS or a phishing email? And the other big question that rises out of the previous one is, if this technology exists with the governments, why don't they use it to capture members of organized crime to put an end to many problems? We are going to reveal evidence of how various Asian and African governments use the surveillance technology to spy on people. Watch the video until the end to find out why they use these systems against journalists, activists, and opposition politicians instead of criminals. Surveillance is extensively used by governments and private companies. One of the widest used, but least famous, is the exploitation of weaknesses in the global mobile telecommunications infrastructure. While first world governments have long had the ability to conduct such activity, in recent years, companies have emerged to sell these capabilities to developing countries. These governments use these capabilities to do surveillance based on SS7 attacks. Using SS7 surveillance tools, they can spy on any phone just by the phone number, and it doesn't matter if the victim is in another country. Victim doesn't have to click a phishing link or open an email or SMS. Yes, you heard right. Just by the phone number. Signaling System 7, or SS7, is a set of telecom protocols developed in 1975 for connecting one mobile phone network to another. SS7 allows phone networks to exchange calls and text messages between each other and to ensure correct billing. It also allows users on one network to roam on another, such as when traveling in a foreign country. At the time of SS7's development, the global phone network consisted of a small number of telecommunications operators. Because these companies generally trusted each other, SS7 designers saw no pressing need to include authentication or access control. But now, the situation is different. Because of SS7's lack of authentication, any person can interconnect with the SS7 network. This person can be an intelligence agency, a cyber criminal purchasing SS7 access, or a surveillance firm running a fake phone company. They can send commands to a victim's home network, falsely indicating that the victim is roaming. This allows them to track the victim's location and intercept voice calls and SMS text messages. Such capabilities could also be used to intercept codes used for two-factor authentication sent via SMS. Even there are cyber criminals who sell these services in the black market for $500. It's very difficult for telecommunications operators to detect if there is any intruder in the network. Today, SS7 is predominantly used in 2G and 3G mobile networks. 4G networks use the newer diameter protocol. Although 4G's diameter protocol includes features for authentication and access control, they are optional. Additionally, the need for diameter networks to interconnect with SS7 networks also introduces security issues. There is widespread concern that 5G technology will inherit the risks of these older systems, thus allowing agencies to spy on 4G or 5G networks. These surveillance systems can cost millions of dollars, and many governments in Asia and Africa have already bought them. If you want to learn how SS7 attack is done to take control of cell phone just by phone numbers, follow us on Facebook and help us reach 10,000 followers. These are different types of mass surveillance systems used by different developing countries. Cipher 360. It processes information from websites, social networks, reviews, news websites, blogs, and creates virtual databases. Conceptus. It extracts information from social networks, messages, photos, and videos, and creates false identities to comment on topics. Pegasus. It infiltrates mobiles and extracts data from calls, messages, emails, contacts, and calendars. Uses the microphone and camera to spy. Avatar. It can extract information from Facebook and Twitter accounts. It creates fake accounts to infiltrate users. BCS. Extracts and consolidates information from different databases to create a profile for each citizen and people surrounding them. Galileo. It can listen to the calls, messages, and steal photos, videos, and documents from the device. Circles. Intercepts calls, messages, and internet traffic. You don't need to be near the target and can be used to spy from another country as it exploits SS7 protocol. Unlike Pegasus spyware, the SS7 attack does not have an obvious signature on a target's phone, such as the telltale targeting SMS bearing a malicious link that is sometimes present on a phone targeted with Pegasus. Researchers from the University of Toronto did an investigation on the use of surveillance systems in different countries and presented evidence about the use of these. They used the Shodan tool for their research. Shodan is a search engine, and its objective is to locate all kinds of devices that are connected to the internet. These devices can be computers, servers, routers, IoT devices, CCTV cameras, etc. While searching Shodan, researchers found IP addresses registered to Circle surveillance systems. These IPs were using checkpoint firewalls called Smart Center and had URL domains of tracksystem.info. Later, they searched on Shodan, Census, and FOFA for checkpoint firewalls and TLS certificates whose hostname domain had tracksystem.info. Both Census and FOFA are search engines similar to Shodan. They found 252 IP addresses that belonged to 25 nation governments. Some of these IPs had two-word nicknames, where the first word is a car brand that almost always shares the same first letter as the country or state of the apparent customer. For example, those of Thailand government are named Toyota, and those of Abu Dhabi government are named Aston. As per the investigation, following are the developing countries where governments use surveillance technology to spy on its citizens through mobile networks. Thailand. They identified three surveillance systems in Thailand named Toyota Regency and Dragon, belonging to the Thai government agencies with these IP addresses. Thailand has a history of leveraging a wide range of surveillance technologies to monitor civil society. Indonesia. They identified two systems in Indonesia with these IPs operated by an unknown agency. Malaysia. Malaysia has two surveillance systems named Pixel Mazda Farmer and Mazda Sky, operated by an unknown agency. Vietnam. Researchers identified a single system in Vietnam called Volvo Halogen, operated by an unknown agency. United Arab Emirates. UAE has three systems with these IPs belonging to the Royal Group. The UAE government is famous for using surveillance technologies to suppress voices. Botswana. Here the government has two surveillance systems named Bentley Boulevard, operated by Botswana's Directorate of Intelligence and Security Service, or DISS. Previously, DISS had engaged in attempts to compromise the privacy of relationships between sources and reporters. Morocco. Researchers identified one system in Morocco belonging to Bureau Central des Investigations Judiciaires, BCIJ, and Moroccan Auxiliary Forces, FA. Nigeria. They identified two systems in Nigeria owned by Nigerian Defense Intelligence Agency, or DIA. A recent report confirmed Nigerian government abusing phone surveillance to target the press. Another investigation by Nigerian newspaper Premium Times found that Nigerian governors spied on their political opponents. Zambia and Kenya. An unknown agency operates a surveillance system in Zambia. Similarly, there's a system called Kali in Kenya. Zimbabwe and Equatorial Guinea. Researchers identified a system named Zagato Zeus and Zimbabwe Telcel with these IPs in Zimbabwe, and one system in Equatorial Guinea. Troublingly, in all of these cases, the government has a history of misuse of surveillance technologies and human rights abuses. Whether you are a journalist, human rights defender, or government employee, we urge you to immediately enable a security PIN or password for your accounts on popular apps such as Signal, WhatsApp, and Telegram. It's also important that you do not give your mobile phone number to the general public or have a number for general public and private use. The private number should be used for banking or confidential matters and must be on another device. If you think you're being spied on, change your number and even the device. This abuse of surveillance technology is widespread. However, it's difficult to investigate, as it doesn't leave any traces on the target's device. Also, there is a lack of transparency from telecommunications providers in these countries, as there is no public reporting from them about the number of attacks identified and blocked, or a roadmap for addressing these in the future. Governments don't want to take the accountability, and so they and their security agencies are spending millions of dollars to resolve their personal problems by targeting journalists, human rights defenders, or their political opponents, instead of using the technology to protect their citizens from organized crime and resolve people's problems. It seems that these governments are not very keen to resolve people's problems, even when they have the power to do so. Do they want their citizens to keep living with problems? Let us know your opinion. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and support us on Patreon. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell icon to get new video updates.